सो वेलकम टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल एंड इट्स अ ब्रांड न्यू डे एंड आज काफ़ी ज़ोर से बारिश हो रही है सुबह सुबह से एंड इट लुक्स लवली। इफ यू आर स्टेइंग समवेयर ऑन द एजेस ऑफ द टाउन आपको नज़ारा काफ़ी अच्छा देखने को मिलेगा। एंड यू नो वॉट, आई एम एक्चुअली नॉट डूइंग दिस रेगुलर स्टाइल व्लॉग, आई एम गोइंग टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट। आज मैं कुछ अलग करने वाला हूँ, सो लेट्स सी इफ यू गाइज लाइक इट। एंड
When I was a kid, I used to love cartoons. And I'm talking about the days when Cartoon Network actually used to show some real cartoons like Ed, and Eddie, Johnny Bravo, SWAT Cats, Dexter's Lab. Man, those were the days. After school, you come home, it was just the TV and me sitting on the floor, hypnotized, transfixed, transported into a different realm. Those were the days, I'm telling you, man. And Animax had just entered India and naturally I was like, wow, cartoons. I know that anime and cartoons are different, but back then I didn't put that much thought about it. So you guys know how violent animes can get at times. And one fine day I was watching Dragon Ball Z and one of the dudes is just getting beaten to a pulp. And my mom just walks in and she goes berserk. She's like, "Ethe fighting dekhi jo mundo kharab hai jiwo," which she said that in Oriya, which translates to, "Don't watch too much violence, you are going to fry your brains." Now this is the same woman who also screams, "Ante ethe cop marks maths re fail auth re fail hai jo jhadu mari mari to chamda utar de." So When she was just shouting at me. So like I used to fail my maths classes quite a bit, and maths is not one of my best strengths. And what she said back then was like, "Once again you have failed in maths, I'm going to beat the shit out of you." What happened to too much violence, mom? So the lesson I learned back then was hypocrisy and hate, just like charity, always begins at home. I love you, mom. It's all good now. And trust me, mom, I am grateful to have you as my mom. So that's all good. But what I was saying is true. Most of us tend to pick up after our parents. The hatred, the violence, the slangs, they're all part of the big deal. And that is something that we can't separate from us. That it comes with a package. It's like the universal law. It's the same concept. It's very similar to how on birthdays you're entitled to get a birthday card. It's like all those birthday cards you get on your birthday. You really don't need another piece of cardboard paper to remind you that you are growing old, your hairline is receding, your skin is not how it used to be, your skin is saggy, and many much more. But man, I really hate birthdays, and more than birthdays, I hate birthday cards, to be honest. If you really hate me, then please remember, sticks and stones may break my bones, but birthday card, that's gonna hurt. That shit will hurt. Now Amazon gift cards are perfectly fine. Hateful and violent speech sticks around us like that annoying neighbor who you always hate. The only way to stay sane is to keep them at the door. Do not let them enter. If they do, then hurl abuses, use words or sentences that show it its place. And I'm not talking about that annoying neighbor here. I have always hated my neighbors, and let me tell you the story behind it. So a few days back, my wife, when she said that she's starting a roasting channel, I was pretty excited. I was like, finally some good fucking food. My wife's a vegetarian and I have dabbled with the idea of vegetarianism. But the idea of roasted veggies, paneer and tofu had got me drooling. And when the next thing that came out of my woman's mouth actually filled my day with disappointment, and my day was entirely ruined. She was talking about opening a comedy roasting channel. And as a good husband, I had no choice but to disappoint her. And I asked her the most difficult question in our relationship. What's for dinner? Anyway, jokes apart, I do support her. I love her. I support her. And if you wanna know, that night I made sandwiches for dinner. And as I was saying, I had to show my support. I started my own research. I started my deep dive into the comedy roasting realm on YouTube, and my research took me to some really dark places. And to simply put it, I wasn't really happy with it either. So I did what any one of you might do in such a scenario. I called up my one good friend and I told him I was gonna start a YouTube channel and what should I do. And he says, bro, the best thing that you can do is just gali de, apna ghussa nikal. And I was like, kis pe bhai? Bro, kuch bhi topic pakad le, gali bhar de ne ka. भाव तो करता है और कर भी रहा है अभी भी, और उसकी तरह कितने लोग भी यही कर रहे हैं, और उन लोगों को देख आज कहाँ पे पहुंच गए हैं. विच इज ट्रू इफ यू लुक एट द इंडियन कॉमेडी एंड रोस्टिंग जॉनर, इट्स फिल्ड विद पीपल हु जस्ट हर्ल अब्यूजेस विदाउट एक्चुअली अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट देयर इज अ फाइन लाइन बिटवीन ह्यूमर एंड साइबर बुलिंग. Anyways, I'm not going to go into that area. Somebody has already done that part and I wasn't convinced. I'm like, no, bro, I just can't. I swear I can't do that shit. Like, if I get angry, I just laugh it off. I'm sorry, I just can't stay angry. Then he goes, bro, I remember you used to fail at maths. I'm like, how is that even related? But then he goes, bro, I remember you used to fail at maths. Didn't your folks, tuition teacher, school teachers shout at you, scream at you, hit you? Didn't you had a Sharma uncle in your neighborhood? Come on, bro, were you even paying attention? And that's when I remembered my Sharma uncle. And that's where I actually had my hatred for neighbors come from. I hated my neighbors and things are probably not going to change. And I know in a way I'm also a neighbor to someone, but you know what? I really miss the part where being nosy, sarcastic, condescending, rude, bitchy, annoying, disrespectful were all parts of how to be a neighbor manual. Man, I had some terrible experiences with neighbors. And one such incident that pops into my head was when I was in Chennai and I used to live alone. I used to work in a BPO and my neighbors used to see me live. The 2 days that I got as my off, often one of my many nosy neighbors could decide to barge in on to check up on me. Are you okay? We didn't see your cab pick up in the morning. We didn't. I mean, seriously, I'm not. You think I'm not? Yeah, that's actually how one of my neighbors used to talk. We didn't see your cab pick up in the morning. Anyways, I don't want to make fun of that. It's bad to make fun of people on how they talk. And I mean, seriously. It's really bad to make fun of people based on how they look or what they wear and how they, like, I've already covered that part. But yeah, like, there are so many good reasons to hate them rather than hating them for their skin color or stuff like that. So you can hate them for being annoying. Anyways, so that's some topic for another day, and I'll just continue with my story here. So yeah. Are you at home? Why are you not at work? Okay, first of all, there's a thing called Sunday, and there's also the concept of 5 days working. And of course, I am at home. I opened the door, didn't I? I know and understand in their own ways. These people, they were just trying to be friendly. They were trying to be nice to me. But you can't do that every weekend. Like, you guys, if you have paid this much attention to where I go, what time a cab comes and all that, then you also know that this weekend I'm at home, and the next Saturday, Sunday also I'll be at home, and the following Saturday, Sunday also I'll be at home. I mean, it's not that hard, don't you see? And the thing is, like, I mean, respect some boundaries, man. And there's this little thing called common sense. I swear it's like our government is taxing people on using common sense, and that's why so many people of them. So, and that's the reason why people don't use common sense. I swear it's like our government is taxing people on using common sense. So that's all for now. I'm gonna go and watch The Way of the House Husband on Netflix. It's a new anime, and I will see you all on my next vlog. So till then, bye.